I want to start off by telling you that as a representative of the Department of Health and Human Services, the government wants to work with you. I think that the particular problem that we're going to talk about today is one that will take all of us working together to solve. We have an obesity epidemic in our country, and it's starting with our youngest citizens.
Partnerships and collaborations, which I think have been key for General Mills and our philanthropic work around obesity. And for us, what we've really talked about, and we began this in 2002, is improving youth nutrition and fitness. The other piece of this, as you talked about, Penny, is our employee engagement. And so we have our employees going out to these schools, doing launches of these physical fitness, really launches of the PALA initiative, and talking to the kids about the importance of fitness, what they do in their daily lives to keep fit, and also talking a little bit about what they do in their daily lives at General Mills. So I think it's helping kids at a very early age understand that fitness and nutrition are important, and here are some simple ways that you can do this. And here's this person who's now working at an interesting place, and here's some things that you might think about for your future. The other piece of this that we were able to combine is we had an independent evaluator evaluate our program at the 5-year mark, and we had a national summit in Washington, D.C. And by doing this, we were able to share our best practices. We brought together the fitness community, the nutrition community. We brought together policymakers and tried to share what we had learned. In addition, we were able to bring many of our grantees into Washington to meet with their particular senator or congressman to talk about their program. And that was another way to help partner with the government and get them to understand the important programs in their local community as well as the national work that General Mills, the President's Council, and the American Dietetic Association was doing together.
But also very important is the idea of advocacy. I think that we can all agree that the private sector in many ways is so much more agile in serving as an advocate, and you can play a significant role in advocating for social change, and you can also play a significant role in advocating for innovation. One of the biggest gifts that I've received since I arrived at the NIH is really leveraging the industry's voice to generate the impetus for change at the NIH. But also very important is the idea of advocacy. I think that we can all agree that the private sector in many ways is so much more agile in serving as an advocate, and you can play a significant role in advocating for social change, and you can also play a significant role in advocating for innovation. One of the biggest gifts that I've received since I arrived at the NIH is really leveraging the industry's voice to generate the impetus for change at the NIH. NIH is a very established biomedical enterprise, and there's a lot of dogma, a lot of old ways of doing things. Every time you want to do something different, people tell you, well, you know, that's the way it is. We've been doing this for decades, you know. But I said, it's not working, you know. We've got to do something different here. Work with me here. And but by bringing partners and fresh voices from the outside, then people start to pay attention. And those sort of almost immeasurable contributions are of tremendous value.
We need to extend our vision of corporate philanthropy and ensure that increasingly it's embedded into the fabric of our business. In PepsiCo, we call it performance with purpose. In practical terms, that means that the senior executives should be evaluated in terms of their contribution, not just to the financial bottom line, but the non-financial bottom line. If that's in place, we know we're seeing serious progress, and I know many companies are starting to do it. Second, our core business, needs to benefit and not harm health or the environment. I think that increasingly we are going to be expected to show coherence between our environment policies and our health policies and our health actions. You can't have a product that benefits health that may be damaging for the environment or the other way around. And certainly in our company, again, we're seeing a uniting of this around the notion of sustainable development, which does provide a unifying force for making sure that the environment and health issues are dealt with not in silos, but in an integrated way. And we can talk about how this plays out for obesity. And then finally, and I think Ellen mentioned this very clearly, I can't say how important it is to agree to independent audit and reporting of what we say we're doing. The more we do this and the more you can show this is a truly independent evaluation, the more we're likely to be able to not just win our place at the table, but to start showing some leadership in some of the circles where we do sit down with government, NGOs, and many others in civil society.